Let's start with our first topic, which is logic and propositions. So what is a proposition? A proposition is a declarative statement. So anything which is having a truth value, which may be true or false, but not both, is called a proposition, right? For example, if I say Delhi is the capital of India. So if I say Delhi is the capital of India, now this is a proposition because Delhi is the capital of India and it is a declarative statement. And here the truth value is true for this statement, right? So if I say Delhi is the capital of United States of America, now the truth value for this statement is false, but it is still a declarative statement. So why? Because it is a declarative statement, that is why we call it, it is there as a proposition. Okay. So if I say discrete mathematics is not mathematics, so for this statement, the truth value is false and it is still a proposition because it is a declarative statement. So if I say 2 plus 8 is equal to 10, it is a proposition, truth value is true. If I say 9 plus 10 is equal to 15, it is a proposition because I'm declaring that 9 plus 10 is equal to 15, right? But here the truth value is false. So in any case, if you can assign a true or false statement to a declarative statement, true or false value to a declarative statement, that then that statement is called as a proposition. Now, if I say, please open the door. If I say, please open the door, that means I'm giving a command, right? It is not a declarative statement. I'm giving you a command that please open the door. If I say, is Delhi the capital of India? So this is a question. I'm asking you a question that is Delhi the capital of India? Now it is a proposition. It is not a proposition. Why? Because it is not a declarative statement. I'm asking you a question. Okay. If I say A plus B is equal to C. In this case, when I'm saying A plus B is equal to C, here A, B and C, all these three are the variables. So there are not any fixed values which are associated with these variables. If you have any fixed value which are associated with these variables, then these variables will become a proposition. Okay. So if I say 9x plus 4y is equal to 8z, here x, y and z, these are the variables. So because these are the variables, they can change their values. That is why this is not a proposition. Because whenever you are having a proposition, the values are already fixed. It is already a declarative statement. Here you are not declaring that it is x, 4x plus 4y is equal to 8z. Why? Because we can change the values of x and y at some point of time. If I say x plus 9 is equal to 18, here I can change the values of x. If I change the value of x to 9, then this proposition will become a true. This will become a true proposition. If I change the value of x as 5, then this will become a false proposition. This proposition is actually dependent on what is the value of x and y. Okay. Now, here you see we can denote all these propositions with the propositional variables. So here the generally used propositional variables are P, Q, R and S. Okay. So just like you denote some kind of variables, if you say x is equal to 5, if you do x is equal to 5, that means you're declaring a variable x, right, in your program. Here we can use with these variables P, Q, R and S to denote propositions. For example, if I say P is equal to Delhi is capital of India. Capital of India. That means this P is denoting the proposition Delhi is the capital of India. Here we should use these semicolons that it is a proposition, because it is a proposition. Okay. So here Delhi is the capital of India. Okay. Now, there are some truth values which are associated with the propositions. Truth values can be true or false. A proposition can be true. A proposition can also be false. Okay. And if we join one or more proposition, then it will become a compound proposition. Now, let us take few examples of propositions. Here, if you see, we are having negation. So, what is a negation? Negation is denoted by this sign or this sign. So it is negation of P in some cases, or in some cases you can find out negation of P. It means that you are doing opposite of P. So generally, if I say you are having a proposition, if you say the proposition P is my name is Himanshu. My name is Himanshu. It is a declarative statement, right? Now, if I do negation of P, the negation of P is actually saying it is not the case. It is not the case that my name is Himanshu. My name is Himanshu. Okay, so it is giving you an opposite of the given proposition. Okay, so in general English, you can say that my name is not Himanshu, right? So if you take this example, so this example I've taken from the book, if you say P denotes the proposition, it is raining today, then what is the negation of P? Negation of P is it is not the case that it is raining today, right? Or in plain English, it can be said that it is not raining today, right? So if you take the second proposition, the proposition is Vandana's smartphone has at least 32 GBs of memory. So it is saying Vandana's smartphone has at least 32 GBs of memory. If it is a proposition, now if you do the negation of this proposition, then you will find out that negation is it is not the case that Vandana's smartphone is having at least 32 GBs of memory. Okay, so which is in turns, if you express the same proposition into a plain English language, then this will say that Vandana's smartphone does not have at least 32 GBs of memory, or Vandana's smartphone has at less than 32 GBs of memory. Okay, so this is how you can represent a proposition, and you can do a negation of a proposition. Okay, now this negation of a proposition has a truth values. So if you do a negation of a particular proposition, it makes a proposition from true to false and false to true. So if you are having the proposition P, then this negation of P will make, if the proposition is true initially, then it is going to make the proposition as false. If the proposition is false initially, then it is going to make the proposition as true. Okay. Now, next is conjunction of two propositions. So conjunction of two propositions is also known as AND of two propositions. If you say there's a proposition P which is denoting my name is Himanshu, and there's a proposition Q which is denoting it is raining today. It is raining today. Then if I do P conjunction with Q, that is P and Q, then it will denote the proposition, which is my name is Himanshu. My name is Himanshu. And it is raining today. It is raining today. Okay. And it is raining today. So if the proposition P is true, and the proposition Q is true, then this P and Q will be true. But if any one of this above proposition is false, then this proposition P and Q is false. Or if both of them are false, then this proposition P and Q is false. Okay, so just you can see in this truth table, if you say the proposition P is true and the proposition Q is true, then obviously P and Q is true. Otherwise, in all the cases, these are false. Okay, you must have studied this kind of logic in your digital electronics subject. So in digital electronics subject, we use AND gate, but here it is the conjunction which is denoting the AND of these two statements, right? So now let us take a few more examples here. Now see, let us see what is a disjunction of a statement. So what is a disjunction of a statement? Disjunction of a statement is denoted by OR, right? So if you say you are having the proposition which is P, which is my name is Himanshu, and there's a proposition Q which is it is raining today, then what is P or Q? So PRQ will denote, my name is Himanshu, my name is Himanshu, or it is raining today. So, or it is raining today. Okay. So if any one of these proposition is true, then the resulting proposition P or Q is true. Otherwise, the resulting proposition is false. Here, assume this my name is Himanshu is true, and this is also true, then this will be true. But if any one of this proposition is, if, for example, this it is raining today is false, then this my name is Himanshu will be, this resulting proposition will be true. For or if the above proposition is false and the below proposition is true, then this will be true. But if both these propositions are false, then the resulting proposition, which is P or Q, will also be false. Okay, you can see this in the truth table. Here, if P is true and Q is true, therefore P and P or Q will be true. If P is true, Q is false, then P or Q will be. If P is false, Q is true, then P or Q will be true. If P is false and Q is false, therefore P or Q will be false. Okay, so this P or Q is actually just saying either this or this. If any one of these two statements will be true, then this will be true, otherwise it is false. Okay, now consider this example. Here in this example, we are saying we are having two propositions. The first proposition is Rebecca PC has more than 16 GBs of free hard disk space, and the proposition Q is saying the processor in Rebecca's PC faster than 1 gigahertz. Okay, and if you do the disjunction of these two statements, that is P or Q, then it is equivalent to saying Rebecca's PC has more than 16 GBs of free hard disk space, or the processor in Rebecca's PC runs faster than 1 gigahertz. Okay, so here you see we are using a OR statement. So this OR statement is saying either if the first statement is true or the second statement is true. If any one of these of these two statements are true, then the resulting of this P or Q will be true, otherwise it will be false. Okay. Now next is the conditional statements. So this is the conditional statement. Conditional statement is saying, if for example you are having a proposition P, which is if I will win the election, I will win the election. Okay, and the proposition Q, which is saying I will lower the taxes. Okay, for example, we are having these two propositions. Now in this case, if you see the truth table is saying if P is true and Q is true, therefore P implies Q is true, right? This conditional statement is also called as implies, implication, right? So if P is true and Q is false, then it is false. Otherwise, it is true in all the cases. Otherwise, it is true in all the cases. So how will you look at this? So for example, if say you are saying P is I will win the election, and Q is a proposition which is saying I will lower the taxes, then what is P implies Q? So P implies Q will give you, if I will win the election, I will win the election, then I will lower the taxes. Then I will lower the taxes. Okay, then I will lower the taxes. Now in this case, if you see, if P is true, for example, if I win the election, then I have to lower the taxes. Otherwise, people will say you haven't done your work, right? So if this is not the case in Indian politics, but still, if I will win the election, then I will lower the taxes, because this is what I promised. I told you if I will win the election, then I will lower the taxes. This is my duty, right? So that is why it is true. But if I win the election and I did not lower the taxes, in that case, I said was false. Right, so in some of the countries, or for example, not in India, but in some other countries, they can actually say, this is not you had fulfilled your promise, that is why you don't deserve to be in politics, right? But here you say, if I will win the election, I will lower the taxes. But when I won the election and I did not lower the taxes, in that case, I am not fulfilling my promises. That is why it is false. That is why it is false. But if I say, if I did not win the election, then there's no foundation on me that I will lower the taxes, right? So if I did not win the election here, if you say in this truth table, if P is false, that means I did not win the election, then I don't have, it is not, I don't have any foundation that I will lower the taxes. It may happen that I will lower the taxes, or it may not happen that I will lower the taxes. For example, if you say the example of Rahul Gandhi. Now, Rahul Gandhi may be having some influence in politics. Even if he did not win the election, he may lower the taxes because of his influences. So he may lower the taxes because of his influences. That is why it is true, right? So he may lower the taxes, but he's not having any foundation after he defeated in the election. So this is, that is why it is true. So he may lower the taxes or he may not lower the taxes, but we're not having any foundations on it, right? So, but if he did not win the election and he did not lower the taxes, we cannot say anything to him, right? So if he did not win the election and still he lowered the taxes, that is why he may be having some influence, that is why he lowered the taxes. But if he did not win the election and he did not lower the taxes, then still we cannot say anything to him, right? So this is the conditional statement. The conditional statement is saying, if P is Q, then Q should also be true. It is saying, in other sense, you can say that if P is true, here you say, if P is true, then Q should also be true. If P is true, then Q should also be true. Now, if P is true and Q is not true, then it is going to give you false. Otherwise, if P is false and there's no foundation on whether the Q is true or not, if P is false, then Q may be true or Q may be false. In both the cases, we are going to return true. Okay, now it is quite confusing in this sense. Let us take few more examples for this propositional, for this conditional statement, and let us see what are different examples of conditional statements. Okay.